While addressing the youths who took part in the 6th Annual Youth Parliament that was hosted in the Chambers of Parliament today, the Minister of State for Youths and Children Affairs, Sarah Mateke, urged the youths to volunteer ideas that can stimulate recovery of youth livelihood program funds following increased cases of defaulting.
So from the effects of COVID-19, when my sister was talking, I wanted to hear now from those youth who took the money, because now this is money for the districts. It is revolving within the district. So if there is no money recovered, you'll find at one point that in Kisoro, I cannot give money to any other group because we have failed to do what? Recover. How do we do it? Because most of the businesses were affected by COVID-19.
Mateke noted that the low recovery rate of the youth livelihood funds is a big concern to the ministry, and they are hatching plans to carry out nationwide engagements of the beneficiaries. She revealed that they are going to empower RDCs to see that defaulters pay.
Very concerned, the recovery rate is very low, and we have decided now to move around the country trying to talk to them, listen to them and find out where is the problem, what happened. Of course, some of them say their businesses collapsed during COVID-19. So now what happens if it collapsed? We have to sit on the table and make another repayment schedule. As we also plan, in fact, some of them who have failed to pay as groups, but who had reached some level, we have agreed, we sit with them, we agree, you finish paying and we add you more money.
According to the Auditor General's report, out of 78.1 billion recoverable funds that were expected from beneficiaries of the Youth Livelihood Programme in 2021-2022 financial year by the Ministry of Gender, only 39 billion was recovered, representing a 50% recovery rate. The youth MPs, Fiona Nyamutoro and Bernard Odoi, explained reasons behind the low recovery of disbursed funds.
The youth fund, especially youth livelihood, was financial literacy. Young people were exposed to accessing credit before they were equipped with the capacity to manage these finances. So most of them ended up having businesses struggling, most of the groups disagreed, but we are glad that with time government noticed the challenge and we had a review of the policy.
I find in an area people create pseudo groups. You find I am the chairperson, then I create pseudo groups of maybe five different groups where I am actually a beneficiary. So you realize that money was channeled to one person through pseudo groups. So at the end of the day, management of this money was not sufficient, supervision was not there, there was no accountability.
Bernard Odoi, the youth representative for Eastern Uganda, says government has to move quickly to arrest youth groups that have failed to pay back, a position Jacob Eyeru, the chairperson of the National Youth Council, is against.
Now, if you don't arrest the other person who took the money and actually did not pay back, how will it revolve back to these other ones who did not benefit? Now, if you don't arrest the other ones, those who take the money subsequently will actually misuse.
That doesn't work. We have tried it and it is leading to forced displacement. Young people are running out of their homes to go into, because someone picks money in Guru, when they are looking for you to arrest, you run to Kampala.
Eyeru wants the government to vary the grace period for the youth livelihood program funds from 6 months to at least 2 years to mitigate cases of default.
The problem with repayment is not just for youth, it's for all the funds of Uganda. And I think it's a business problem, it's not a will problem, because by the time people are picking this money, the guidelines are clear that they are picking money that's a loan, that is not a grant, so you're not just going to do what you want. So it's a business problem. Many of the people that pick this money are not very well trained in business.
By 2021, the Youth Livelihood Program, designed as one of the interventions of government in response to the high unemployment rate and poverty among the youths, had disbursed 314.672 billion shillings since its inception in 2013, and over 39.102 billion shillings has been recovered. The program contributed 4% to job creation in Uganda, with over 200,000 direct jobs and 500,000 indirect ones. Story by Fred Kajibi for the news.